Hey, this is DJ from DJSTRAINS. Now, my last video, I showed you how we made this hill and how we made the rocks the right color. Now, we're going to look at this layout and give an overview of the first section. And this is North Bessemer Yard. It starts with XB Tower, which you just saw there. And still to come will be the branch to the Unity Railways. Now, the North Bessemer Yard section that I'm building is 5 tracks. It's a mix of Atlas, Cato, Peco track, and I even have 2 tracks that are going over to the car shops. And I still have to build the car shops building, the yard office, but one of the scenes that's mostly finished is the old engine house. Now a little bit of history. The Bessemer Lake Erie engine house still stands. And even though all the engines are now being serviced up in Greenville, the building's still here. It's falling apart, but it's a pretty cool place to model. Now I'm modeling 1987, and then certain times I'm probably going to run stuff from maybe like the 60s or 70s. Now the yard is used still every day, where the Bessemer brings in a train of ore, leaves it for the union, who picks it up, and they exchange empties there also. Back in the day, the union brought them a lot of coal, coke, steel products, and there was even a period of time in the 60s and 70s that the Bessemer had a piggyback operation. And I thought that was a really cool thing to model also. So I'm leaving the piggyback operation in, and that's off of one leg of the Y. But going back to the engine house, I scratch built that basically from sheet styrene and also from, I think they're calling it now the Union, Union Shovel, and it was a Dayton Machinery thing, N-scale building. And I just kind of changed some walls around and made it pretty much to scale. It looks pretty good. Now as for the piggyback operation, it's still a work in progress, but I scratch built the ramp and the loading dock, and that was just from, let's say I used some brick styrene and just regular styrene that I painted to look like wood. But if we follow the yard to the south end, we'll see that the railroad enters North Bessemer Tunnel. Now North Bessemer Tunnel is 3,000 feet long. If you want to convert that to N scale, you want to make it to scale, you need 18 feet to do that. So here's what I want to talk about in this video is, instead of using 18 feet, all you're going to need is 1 inch. So take a look at a tunnel. What's the most important thing you see is just the portal, the front of it. You don't really know how long it is, and it's that mystery, and that's what we want to convey. So we want to have a scene where we just see the train appearing. So how we're going to do this is by using hardboard. Now simple hardboard, I mean, you can use it for your backdrop, you can use it for your fascia, and you can use it as scene dividers. I love working with this stuff. So I nailed some 2x4s just to give it some support. I'm sorry, I screwed some 2x4s on here to give it support. And then I just mounted a 13-inch high piece of hardboard. And I cut out the opening. And then also using hardboard, I made nice fascia. And I had it, you can cut this stuff pretty easy. And once you get it cut to a nice contour and you mount it there, you can start on your scenery. I'm not going to go into big detail about how I do the scenery in this video, but basically all it is a simple foam board. I use newspaper, plaster cloth, and then I went over it with sculpt-a-mold, colored sculpt-a-mold that you'd learn a lot from that last video about how to do the rocks. So right now I'm waiting for it to all dry, and then once it dries, I'm going to go over it with the foliage material, and I'm going to use the polyfiber to make the bushes and the trees. And I'm going to have it all match as close as I can to the photo backdrop that's going to be against the far wall. Now, for the hardboard that's our scenery divider, now I'm not an artist, but what I did is I got some light blue latex paint and painted the sky, and then just using just simple acrylics, I pretty much dabbed on the forest, and then I liquid nailed the portal on, and the portal's a Woodland Scenics one that just lightly weathered and painted. And so here's what it looks like when the train's coming out of the tunnel. Now, some of you may look closely and say, well, hey, I can still see that plywood from the other side. Yes, because I haven't started working on the other side yet. But when I do, and you see, when you look through, what you're going to see is simply hillside, but it's going to be so dark that it's going to look like the inside of a tunnel. Also, where it's at right now, I'm looking directly at it. But if you look closely here, this is where most people working the layout are going to see. They may see just a glimpse of the portal, but this is where the operator standing is going to see the train simply disappear. So what I hope you've taken from this video is you don't need 18 feet to make this long tunnel. The longer the tunnel, that's where you're going to have your derailments. That's where your train's going to get stalled. That's where the track gets dirtiest. It's just Murphy's Law. So you can still convey the idea of having a tunnel and the train disappear into parts unknown, but just do it smarter and by focusing where your viewer sees. So if you have any questions, ideas, or comments, email me at djstrains@yahoo.com. See my website, www.djstrains.com. And you can even follow me on Twitter, just under DJSTRAINS. All right, guys, you guys gave me some great ideas for upcoming videos, so please subscribe to my channel if you haven't done so. Good stuff coming your way, and these are all ideas from you guys. So if they suck, it's your fault. My videos don't suck. So why are you still watching the credits? You really watching the credits? You know, I'm just making this stuff up as I go along, right? You can click off now. Stop watching.